Hello again. We're coming in on another Sabbath day, so I'm going to talk about Sabbath yet again. In Philippians, Paul talks about Christ being poured out, being made human, giving up much that we would have life. He then, later in the same chapter, will talk about his own life this way. Yes, and if I am being poured out as a drink offering on the sacrifice and service of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with you all. You see, Paul's trying to make the link. Jesus comes, becomes vulnerable, dies, saves his children, and his children then have the ability to share the message, to share the love, the compassion, and the acceptance that they find in Christ. They have the power to do that here, now, where they didn't before. And Paul is modeling this in his own actions. One of the fundamental calls of Christians is to be part of God's kingdom, and part of that is expanding the kingdom. Just as the universe is always expanding on the rim, you know that? Just like that, the kingdom is growing. And we all have a call, we all have a point, we have a purpose within that. But we can't be doing that all the time, right? Paul could do it because, as he mentioned earlier, Christ did it for him. David Murray wrote a book called Reset, and here's a bit of a paraphrase of some of it that I think is helpful. He says, Christians, not ministers, not elders, not bishops or cardinals or popes, Christians, all of us, who refuse to receive the grace of a weekly Sabbath, the grace of sufficient sleep, the grace of physical exercise, the grace of family and friends, or the grace of Christian fellowship. These are gifts God has given us. Yes, it is more blessed to give than to receive, but if we don't do any receiving, our giving soon dries up. One way to measure how we are doing spiritually is to consider how are we doing at helping others? How are we helping them physically and tangibly in the world, and how are we helping them spiritually? Are we being encouraging? Are we praying for people? Are we praying with people? And if we find that we're not doing any of these kind of things that you would expect a Christian to be able to do, then there's something askew in our own personal spiritual life. And my guess is there's a few things that we really fail to do. We often fail to pray. We often fail to read our Bibles on a regular basis and thus be fed by the Word of God. But also, we fail to practice Sabbath. We fail to trust God Himself to take care of the world for a day. And we fail to trust God to renew us and refresh us. Maybe we think it's lazy. Maybe we think it's selfish. Whatever the reason is. Maybe we just think we're so important the world can't handle a day without us. God can handle it, okay? So, for us to be able to fulfill our commitment as priesthood, the priesthood of all believers, we really must be taking a Sabbath. We must be finding ways to block out chunks of time to rest in God. This isn't a time to sit and drink beside the pool. It's a time for true recreation, recreating, renewing, refreshing, and also reconnecting with God. And we're called to do that at least once a week. And I pray that each of you would be able to find a way to do that. And in the summertime, if you get a little more time off, if you have like a week, 2 weeks, whatever it is, if you can do some kind of project that will help you, even if it's 10 minutes a day, to reconnect with God, use some of that time that you have to reconnect with God. It's not stealing time from your kids or your spouse or your grandkids. It's renewing yourself so that you can pour out to your kids and your grandkids and your spouse and all your other relationships. For like Paul, we are called to be poured out as drink offerings in the service of the faith of others. If we do that and we do it well, we'll find great satisfaction. We'll find our churches having more people in them. We'll find more of our family and friends being part of the faith. And we'll find just a blessed shalom. And that's what we want, isn't it? That's what God wants for us. And He tells us how to get it, and it includes a Sabbath. So let's take a day.